My name's Gabi. I'm from Rochester, New York. When I was 12 years old, I started feeling a pain in my stomach, and it lasted for a long time. I didn't really say anything because it kind of came on really, really slowly, and it's just not something I'd ever experienced. I was always really healthy, really active, liked to go horseback riding. I was really into playing softball, soccer. The pain was mostly after I would eat. Sometimes it would be aching and sometimes it would be a sharp pain. It was one of those things where like I could just be sitting watching TV and then all of a sudden like this intense pain would be in my stomach. And finally I went in for my physical before starting school, and when they weighed me I had lost like 15 pounds. And you know, there was a lot of speculation on like why that might have happened, and I told them that I was in so much pain. That's when I was referred to a gastroenterologist. Along with the pain, I was also going to the bathroom 15 to 20 times a day, and it was diarrhea, sometimes it was like water, and it was just, that's when the pain was most intense too. And so when I was put on the steroids, they made it seem like that was going to be the solution. You know, you go on these steroids, it's not forever, you know, you might have to be on some sort of maintenance medication. I was just going to go back to living my normal life. That's not at all what happened. I probably had every side effect that I could even imagine from the steroids. I graduated high school and, you know, that was fine. And then I went to a community college and lived at home. And I started to get really sick. Started to kind of feel like I didn't really have control of when I went to the bathroom. And they ended up admitting me to the hospital. I was fed by a PICC line, and they did like a CT scan and colonoscopy, and my large intestine was pretty much just like so inflamed and so red, and it like there it was so narrowed from the inflammation, and there were these giant sores on it. And they showed me the pictures, and then they showed me what a normal intestine, healthy intestine should look like, and it's supposed to be pink and just like smooth. And after like a month of them trying to, you know, give me the medications intravenously, they sent in the surgical team to start discussing options that way. And they basically told me that they were going to do a total colectomy and take out my large intestine, but leave just enough that I would still be able to hold waste, and then I would still have my small intestine. At the same time, that was not a cure, because with Crohn's disease, it can come back anywhere in your digestive tract. The doctors had told me too, you know, if you don't do the surgery now, there's a chance that the inflammation will get so bad that none of the food will be able to get through, and then you'll have a blockage, and you know, your intestines could perforate or tear, and then you'll have to have emergency surgery, so you won't necessarily be able to be reconnected when it's over with. That scared me more than anything, because I didn't want to live the rest of my life with an ostomy. I was like so concerned with how it would look, you know, will you be able to see it through your clothes? Is it gonna just fall off? So I went through with the surgery, and like nothing is like the pain that I woke up with after the surgery. It was so bad. The doctors had me on all sorts of pain medication, and I was like really out of it all the time. And my mom called in the nurse, and they did vitals on me, and my blood pressure dropped so low, and then my heartbeat was like 160 beats a minute. And when I told them about how I felt, like my stomach was really distended, they immediately got a team and put an NG tube down my nose, and it drained the equivalent of a 2-liter bottle of this like green slimy fluid. It turns out that I had gone septic, and they had to do emergency exploratory surgery to see if they could find out what happened. My surgeon really wasn't able to pinpoint why I went septic. I was able to go home, but I had to have a visiting nurse come every couple days to help me like change the bandage, and I ended up getting really sick again. I had an obstruction, and food could not get through part of my small intestine, because that's where the inflammation had come back. Anything that I ate or drank, I would throw up. So I went in the hospital, and when I finally agreed to another surgery, this surgeon was very, very straightforward with me and very honest and said, you were lucky the first time that they were able to reconnect you and have the reversal surgery. This time, you might not be so lucky. And he said, I will do everything I can, but I'm gonna be honest with you, it's like a 50-50 chance. And I won't know until I really get in there. It was almost a relief because that was the first time that a doctor has been that blunt with me and that honest. I had the surgery, it was the day after my birthday, and I woke up with another ostomy. And waking up from the surgery, my surgeon told me, hang in there and get better, but I do think that I will be able to reverse this. That gave me some hope. And this time around, I knew what to expect. I knew what the ostomy, I knew exactly what it was gonna be like. I had some complications with that surgery, but I didn't have the healing issues that I did with the first one. So 8 months later, I was able to go in and was able to reverse it. So since the reversal surgery, I decided to take on a vegan diet, and I've honestly felt better than I have since I first started having symptoms when I was 12 years old. My advice for someone who's newly diagnosed with Crohn's disease is to just be informed and ask questions. And you have to find someone that you can truly talk to and who listens to you. You have to be your own advocate or have someone that knows you and really can advocate for you. You know yourself best, and if something's not working for you, you need to speak up and tell them that. At the end of the day, you just have to be informed and do what's right for you, because what is right for someone else and what has worked really great for them may not be the best option for you.